Hybrid Albedo. Half man, half woman. Can be a mother, a father, of a child. Hurry along now, you're just in time.
AmarA, I'm coming to you live from the Bundy Museum in Binghamton, New York. We're going to take a quick tour of this historic site, which also houses the Rod Serling Archive, the Clock Room. Ah, it's a ton of shit. Just come on, let's check it out.
This is the Bundy Museum of History and Art.
Isn't this beautiful? All right, so this is our newest space at the Bundy Museum. We opened up our barbershop to make it bigger and a little brighter. And we've also installed a beautiful bar space. This is our concession area. So this is our clock exhibit. This exhibit will tell you everything you've ever wanted to know about the history of IBM, how that company started, what products they started out making, and I'll give you a hint, they're in this room. And some of the people involved in the growth and development of that company. So if you've ever had to clock in to work on a time clock, you can thank the Bundy Manufacturing Company for that, because they created the first commercially viable time clock for employees to use. So when I come to work at the Bundy Museum every day, I clock in on this clock. Not really. But you can clock in on this clock, and you can take home your time card too. So now that you've seen the house, let's take a look at the annex. This space used to be a carriage house 100 years ago, but now it houses the exhibits of the Bundy Museum of History and Art. We have a number of exhibits to see back here, including our Southern Tier Broadcasters Hall of Fame that highlights the careers of so many people who were instrumental in television and radio broadcasting here in the Triple Cities area. And our most famous native son is Rod Serling. We have an exhibit gallery that is completely dedicated to Rod Serling and his work. The Rod Serling Archive Room can This room houses photographs and magazines and comic books and all sorts of Rod Serling memorabilia for you to see and to take your time exploring. We've got a bookshelf full of DVDs and books. You can kick back in this room, screen your favorite episodes of The Twilight Zone on our retro television. Yes, it really works.
What's your favorite thing in here?
My favorite thing in here, well, would have to be the Binghamton High School yearbook that contains a quote from Rod Serling. Not many people know that Rod Serling grew up in our little town of Binghamton, New York, and he graduated from Binghamton High School right down the street. In 1972, he gave the keynote speech at the high school commencement.
Thank you. Or maybe a math whiz that acted out all his biggest dreams the others laughed at. You react through retract and redact your nerd act.
The impact was as subtle as a GTA carjack. Take your licks like a hero, it's a matter of course. Stay true to your roots because you're strong in the force. Take the beatings, banter, broken words, rip you apart. CS is Ben and Yoda, trust these words we impart. Don't sell your soul for less gil than it's worth, because the geek shall inherit the earth.
With jubilant mirth, the humor is quirk that jerks my work is drones. It's a nerco revolution, bitch, attack of the pwns. Survival of the leaders, evolution of those more bright.
Fall behind while nerds rise up like phoenix rise.
Don't be perturbed by the riots that we incite.
Now all padawans become Jedi Knights, cause
this is the sound of nerdcore. Knocking at your door, knocking at your door. This is the sound of nerdcore, knocking at your door, knocking at your door. This is the sound of nerdcore, knocking at your door.
Hello, folks. I'm the artist AmarA. I'm coming to you live from the Bundy Museum in Binghamton, New York. We're going to take a quick tour of this historic site, which also houses the Rod Serling Archive, the Clock Room. It's a ton of shit. Just come on. Let's check it out.
This is the Bundy Museum of History and Art.
Isn't this beautiful? All right, so this is our newest space at the Bundy Museum. We've opened up our barbershop to make it bigger and a little brighter. And we've also installed a beautiful bar space. This is our concession area. So this is our clock exhibit. This exhibit will tell you everything you've ever wanted to know about the history of IBM, how that company started, what products they started out making, and I'll give you a hint, they're in this room. And some of the people involved in the growth and development of that company. So if you've ever had to clock in to work on a time clock, you can thank the Bundy Manufacturing Company for that, because they created the first commercially viable time clock for employees to use. So when I come to work at the Bundy Museum every day, I clock in on this clock. Not really. But you can clock in on this clock, and you can take home your time card too. So now that you've seen the house, let's take a look at the annex. This space used to be a carriage house 100 years ago, but now it houses the exhibits of the Bundy Museum of History and Art. We have a number of exhibits to see back here, including our Southern Tier Broadcasters Hall of Fame that highlights the careers of so many people who were instrumental in television and radio broadcasting here in the Triple Cities area. And our most famous native son is Rod Serling. We have an exhibit gallery that is completely dedicated to Rod Serling and his work. The Rod Serling Archive Room can This room houses photographs and magazines and comic books and all sorts of Rod Serling memorabilia for you to see and to take your time exploring. We've got a bookshelf full of DVDs and books. You can kick back in this room, screen your favorite episodes of The Twilight Zone on our retro television. Yes, it really works.
What's your favorite thing in here?
My favorite thing in here, well, would have to be the Binghamton High School yearbook that contains a quote from Rod Serling. Not many people know that Rod Serling grew up in our little town of Binghamton, New York, and he graduated from Binghamton High School right down the street. In 1972, he gave the keynote speech at the high school commencement.
Thank you.